Welcome back, everybody. It's Ty.
And Jenny.
And tonight we're going to do a beer here. Hold on a second. This just does not look right. There we go.
You need to be ready.
I try. I'm never ready.
But you do that almost every time.
Yeah, well, what can I say? I should have, like, gaffer's tape and mark off my spots like people do in movies and TV shows. They have their mark. Where's my mark? I missed my mark.
When your mark gets set, go.
Okay. So look what I have here. What's it say, honey?
High Cliff IPA.
What's it say underneath that?
6 12-ounce bottles, 6.2 alcohol by volume.
Yes. Where do we buy this?
Price Chopper?
No, we bought this at Stewart's.
Stewart's Dairy.
Yes, Stewart's Shops. Stewart's Shops. Stewart's Shops is like 7-Eleven in upstate New York. Matter of fact, there's no 7-Elevens anywhere. There's a Stewart's, basically. I don't know if it's like with the Yakuza Mafia or something like that, or why it is, but 7-Eleven does not compete with Stewart's Shops. I don't know if there's some, you know, backroom deal, you know, like.
And Stewart's is not that widespread.
No, but they have a large enough region. I mean, they go in Massachusetts, they go a little bit, not much. They have more Vermont, but it's mostly upstate New York. It goes down south now, but it started in Saratoga, New York. That's where they're from. And they have great milk. I like their milk. And their gas station. So just think of it like, I don't know, their dairy is really good because it's local and really good. So they have their own beers that they sell in their stores. And usually they're made by Genesee, like their ice beer and their regular beer. And it's just basically Genesee in another can. This actually is a little interesting. So this is High Cliff IPA. It says here, brewed exclusively for Stewart's Shops, Saratoga Springs, New York, by Schmaltz Brewing Company, Clifton Park, New York.
So I have no idea all this about Stewart's.
About?
But they have their own beer bottling.
They don't bottle it. No, they just they have Genesee bottle it with their label on it. Just like, you know how when you go and buy store brand things, but sometimes they're just brand name stuff with a different label on it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I had to try this because it's an IPA. Alright, so. This glass has got something on top. Oh, it's lipstick. I don't care.
And I did watch.
Oh, it smells really good.
This goes to show.
Now, this is 6.2%. Yeah.
That's an interesting smell.
There's no mention on this as to what.
It's good.
Yeah, it doesn't say on here what kind of hops are in this, so we're just going to find out. Now, I've bought Schmaltz Brewing beers before, and they're all right. They're actually pretty good, but when you compare them to, like, those world-class beers, they just don't compare, but they're still good. You know, if you're looking at like, oh, I'm going to compare it to, you know, Treehouse or Monk or...
like the Berenstain Bears Treehouse. Sorry.
No, it's funny. Trillium or... I like Single Cut a lot, but that's like, there's like these big breweries. Not really big, they're small, but they're the ones that are like the world-class beers. And Schmaltz is kind of, they're more like better than Sam Adams, but not as good as something else. Like Sam Adams used to be like the good beer.
Although in fact, in the beginning, it was all like new, like, wow, Sam Adams.
Yeah, smaller brewery, microbrewery, you know?
Like 20 years ago, and now it's just like.
Yeah, well, they're big now. But, I mean, Yingling is the one that was always good.
And now you don't think anything of them.
That's not true. I like Yingling.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
You kind of just
well,
like,
when
yeah,
I'm buying
just
stuff,
like, yeah.
Well, I'd rather yeah. buy something different. I don't know.
And then it's you like, end up getting Genesee.
Well, Genesee's good.
You never get me St. Pauli Girl.
I never see it.
I have no idea if that's any good anymore.
I have to go to a place to get it. So here, you get the lipstick one just because it's less in it. Although they're kind of... This has got a huge head on it. What do you say sorry for?
Because you're always cutting me off.
I don't mean to cut you off. I'm thinking about the next thing I'm going to say.
Is that lipstick?
Yeah,
I think it's like rubber cement.
I don't think it's rubber cement.
Cement. I mean, I don't care. Don't bother me. But it's just that I don't use gray black lipstick that's the texture of rubber cement.
Okay, I'm kind of getting some Pacific Northwest smell, the hops, and mosaic. That's how I'm smelling.
Mosaic?
Hops, yeah.
Well, I won't be able to discuss that.
Okay, so let's, what do you smell?
All I can do is compare it to, it smells like something nice that we had at the B-side.
All right. Let's give it a try.
But different. It just has an interesting taste. Very, very subtle. Nothing I've ever tasted before.
There's pine in there. It's good. It's very piney. It's actually really good. I like it. Yeah, this is a good beer. I like it a lot. Surprisingly, that it's so... I mean, I can buy this at Stewart's. What was this? I think it was $8.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
$7.99 or $8.99, something like that. But yeah, you were really like, oh, yeah, it's just...
Is this one I bought?
You said whatever. Yeah, this is the one that when you first were looking at it on the shelf, you were like, oh, look at that, what's this? And then you're like, oh, it's just... And then whatever.
I knew it was Stewart's. I did, yeah. I was hoping it was going to be something weirder, you know?
You're like, oh, never mind.
Well, because I know
then
Schmaltz.
You went back for Schmaltz.
Schmaltz.
And... I don't know what you mean by that comment.
Well, Schmaltz makes good beer, but it's nothing that blows you away. You know, it's just like, oh, this is a good beer. You're not, if someone gives this to you, you're not like, oh, what's this swill you gave me? It's like, it's good. You know, it's good. You're not like, you remember that beer? I need to have some more of that beer. That beer was good. I want that. I want Billy Fullstack, and I can't have Billy Fullstack. I need Billy. By the way, they're doing a double dry hopped Billy Full Stack version.
And when is that going to be out, and how hard is that going to be to get?
Really hard, unless I go down to Queens to get it.
Queens!
Yeah. High Cliff IPA. It's good. Cheers. What do you think? Is it good?
It was good. It is good.
The head is massive on that, though. And I poured that. That was not a hard pour at all. That was straight on the side. That's what I like about these glasses. You can pour them without getting a giant head.
Almost has that boozy bourbon barrel type taste, but not really over the top.
A 6.2, it tastes boozy. That's funny. I don't get a lot of alcohol out of it. It's just good.
Well, I guess that I'm not understanding. When you say that, when you describe things in that way, it tastes like you're licking a dirty old barrel
there's
of
heat.
Wood.
There's the heat of the alcohol in it.
Oh, so that's not what I thought you meant when you say that. When you say, because you
it's
know,
like whew, you feel it. It's like,
oh,
that it's evaporating in your mouth.
My taste is just all wrecked or something. I just feel things differently because when you describe that, you say, oh, it's boozy. Like, and bourbon barrel aged beer. And I'm like, okay, so that's why it is like...
smoky? Well, there's the oak barrels and things like that. But I'm talking about, forget that part, getting the taste of the barrel. You need to say something? Say, blah, blah. Well, I kind of, pretty regular that.
I just wanted to say that when you say that, I think, okay, like, you know how when you go to an old barn... and there's an old wood bucket that's all rotted and with like little black bits of crap in it that's rotten wood. And then you sniff it or lick it And then you get
I'm literally tearing up from this.
I'm sorry.
No, because it's so funny.
Oh, well, you get that taste, or think of that taste or smell, because for me, taste and smell sometimes is the same, sometimes it's different. But that concept of stinky old rotten wood, that's what I thought that you meant when you say boozy barrel aged in a bourbon boozy barrel.
Like, where do you get that from?
From you. When you said that, and you're like, get and drink it, and that smell, you're like, smell that, that's because it, or taste that, that's because it's aged in a bourbon barrel. Beer aged in a bourbon barrel.
Okay, there's two separate things. There's barrel aged, okay, mm-hmm. which imparts the oak flavor and the flavor from the bourbon. Okay? You're going to get a little bit of alcohol from it. What are you getting all sad about?
Because I just don't understand anything anymore. And I used to be... I used to be smart.
Let me make you understand. You ready?
Yes.
Okay, so you get... The bourbon barrel is not boozy. Okay? You might get boozy because it might be high alcohol content, but it's completely separate. The barrel agedness gives you that flavor as if you're getting some of the bourbon flavoring, but not necessarily the booze flavor from it. And you get, you're getting the wood and the oak, just like it from wine barrels, have that oak smoky flavor, okay? If you're smelling some old skanky, dirty, dusty wood, that ain't good. That's gross. But that's all, you know, you get that whole soil taste and other things. You know, so
me?
Yes, from your MS.
Well, I'm just like, you know how they say that dogs can dogs can separate the smells and discern different smells very well. Well, I'm not saying that I'm some kind of really good at that. But I'm just saying that when you say something, I'm like, okay, yeah, I'll, like, take out all the smells and, like, what's the word? Not document, but separate them into categorize. Oh my God. Okay, folks, we'll see you next time.
No, I wanted to say the other part, the booziness. Yes, you can separate every smell out of the planet. And you can, she can smell anything. Mm-hmm. Like, she could smell duty from a mile away. We have kids, and they poop somewhere. She can find it.
Duty.
So I said the whole part about the barrel age, right? The booziness is that evaporative rubbing alcohol, but not rubbing alcohol, but you ever, you know, you take a shot, you put in your mouth, and it's like, and it's like effervescing, it's like evaporating.
And it's rubbing alcohol-y. Yeah.
Yes. That's the booziness. And there's some beers that are very boozy. You know what I'm saying by boozy?
I understand what you're saying with that, but
so
I've not.
Some
I've
some,
not.
This is low alcohol
that.
Content. This is 6.2. It's not high. Some of them are high. And they don't taste boozy. Some of them are less alcoholic, but still higher, but they taste boozy.
So the boozy is only the rubbing alcohol effervescent, woo, in your nose.
Yeah, it tastes like booze.
Okay, see, I've never gotten that from any of the things that you have me try. All I get is that going to an old antique barn and finding a dirty old bucket and licking it.
I don't usually give you beers that taste boozy, so.
You have? Well, you... You say, and you say it's got that boozy bourbon barrel taste. It's bees.
Okay. Yes. What?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Anything else?
No.
You're done. Say goodbye.
Goodbye.
All right, I'm gonna stop now.